Tonight on Kitchen Nightmares, Mojito's Cuban Cafe feels like the set of a soap opera that stars two hot Latin lovers. They were once romantic newlyweds.
Everybody said, you are the perfect couple.
Proud owners of a restaurant they treated like a newborn baby.
It's everything for me.
Today, the passion is gone. The marriage is over, and the business is on the rocks.
Get together, Marcelo! Control!
Listen, I try to control everything!
She used to show respect for me. No, no.
Do it now! The person that I was married to? He's gone.
Always at each other's throats.
I want to kill her.
The staff is constantly caught in the crossfire.
Who's trying to sabotage this?
That's all we hear every day. We probably do then too.
Catalina and Marcelo's constant fighting.
Let me talk.
Is definitely hurting the restaurant.
To save Mojitos, Chef Ramsay must find out what killed the marriage.
Did she meet another man?
Yeah. Do you love him?
Or these two soulmates will see the death of their dream.
Not doing it right because it's not perfect.
Follow my kitchen.
Tonight. The soap opera of Mojitos.
Do you think it's time that one of you says goodbye?
Marcelo should quit, but I'll go to the end.
Brooklyn, New York. Just across the East River from Manhattan, this historic neighborhood has become a hip and trendy place to live. 7 years ago, Cata and Marcelo moved here just after they got married.
We always wanted to have a restaurant and wanted to make a dream come true.
We decided to open a restaurant, Mojitos, a Cuban food. We live together upstairs in the apartments.
Hi guys, how are you? Welcome. Marcelo and I, we both come out with different specials all the time. I've been cooking my whole life, and I love it. We share responsibilities of the restaurant. He takes the back house, and I take the front house.
I do the food, the orders, the payroll. I do everything.
But a year after we opened the restaurant, things started going very bad.
Cata!
Marcelo and I are constantly fighting.
Just serve the rice. Serve the rice. You're right there.
Yes, we are on it.
Marcelo, why don't you listen to me?
No, let me finish in my way. In my way.
No. She have the book, How Drive Marcelo Crazy. First, say you don't do nothing.
Isn't that your responsibility?
Second, clap.
Do it now.
Okay, cheese a bitch.
That's not the way you make it. I don't respect Marcelo because he doesn't know how to handle pressure.
Where is the guava and cheese here? You're the chef and you don't know?
They will fight in front of customers.
Pick up the food on time.
It gets ugly.
Because of the fighting, we separated 2 years ago.
I get another apartment in Queens and I live there.
We destroyed our marriage and I don't want to destroy my restaurant. There's no money in the bank?
Zero.
We have invested everything we have, like $300,000. If I lost the restaurant, I will lose my dream. I love my baby. This is my baby.
I sacrificed for Mojitos my relationship.
But it's Cata.
The most important thing I have. Mojitos destroy our lives. Sorry.
Mojitos, the restaurant I'm about to visit, what I do know is it's the only Cuban restaurant in Brooklyn, so that has to be a big plus. But what I don't know is, why do they need my help? Right. Well, hello. Hi. Hello.
First name is?
Catalina.
Catalina. Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
Excellent. And you're the?
I'm one of the owners, Latch. Chef.
Okay.
I have a partner. Marcelo is his name.
Right.
We used to be married. We've been separated for 2 years.
You used to be married?
To my partner.
Oh,
it's just like water and oil. We just don't mix anymore. And it's just like conflict all the time.
Well, it's all about the food. I'll have a look through the menu. Nice to meet you.
Same here. Okay, bye-bye. Enjoy your lunch.
Thank you.
Oh, my God.
A real interesting decor, yeah. It's almost like a sort of garage sale gone wrong. How are you, sir?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, very indeed, thank you. Let's start off with chicken classic soup. Let's go for the pescado marinara, the tilapia. Yeah?
Absolutely.
I really believe Chef Ramsay gonna like the food. I think that 97% of my food will be great.
Thank you very much. That was very fast. Very fast indeed. Let's hope it's good. It's cold. I don't want to be a pain in the ass, but can I have the soup hot? It's cold.
Hot. It's cold. Wow. Let me get that hot for you, okay?
Please.
Absolutely. He would like a hot soup, not cold.
Who said that?
Ramsay said.
What happened with the soup?
I have a thermometer here, boiling hot. You want to check? You want to check with me?
It wasn't boiling hot?
And now it's
boiling hot. Listen.
Now it is, but when it went out, it was.
Before you guys send something out, please check, double check, triple check, check one more time.
Yes, yes.
Listen, go to your bar.
I'm sorry about that.
Don't worry. Just when I went to taste these are so salty. I mean, you'd need 6 mojitos before you start eating 6 spoons of that.
You're right.
They're disgusting.
Excuse me, let me take this back.
What a shame. I couldn't get the basics right.
Do me a favor. Try the beans. Marcelo, try the beans. Salty as hell. Throw it out. Get it together, Marcelo. Control.
Listen, I try to control everything.
Let me fix the cheese.
Okay, focus.
Get out of here.
No,
it's
my kitchen.
Oh, my God. There's definitely a lack of harmony in the kitchen.
It's not getting cold. Instead of arguing, do it now.
I want this one right like now. Oh, my God. That's going to be a complete disaster.
Bring the beans and do what you have to do.
Now go out here.
I'm not going out.
Go out here.
I'm not.
Go out of my kitchen.
No.
Go out of my kitchen. Go out of my kitchen. Now.
How you doing?
Yeah, fine, thank you. And you?
I'm fine. Can I get you anything else while you wait
for... No, I'm going to wait for the tilapia.
Okay.
Thank you.
I hope it comes out right.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Wow, I know. I can't believe it. The beans, the basic of us.
I hope you enjoy it, because it's actually my favorite dish.
Thank you.
Delicious. Wow. You love it.
Yeah, he loves it.
Fish is not cooked.
Fish is not cooked. Ah, it's really not. That is a shame. I'm gonna bring it back. That's a very big mistake on behalf of the kitchen.
¿Qué pasó?
Not cooked. Raw fish.
What's wrong with you guys? It's raw. It's raw. Not cooked.
I put the tester, the oven tester.
No, sir. This is raw.
Raw.
This never comes raw. What's wrong? Hey! Excuse me. Center Catalina, please. Marcelo cannot handle pressure. He should not be in the kitchen at all. 1, 2, 3 filters and everything's coming out wrong? Unbelievable. Goodbye.
Coming up on Kitchen Nightmares.
I'm the boss here. You have to listen to me.
The chaos goes from bad to worse. Kata is out of control.
Marcelo, get out of the kitchen. Get out of the kitchen.
And Marcelo is out the door.
What's wrong with this guy?
Then you're not going to believe what's hidden downstairs.
No.
Chef Ramsay's shocking discovery that makes everyone sick.
I could not believe my eyes.
Can Chef Ramsay bring these two together and get the restaurant back on track?
Do you think it's time that one of you says goodbye?
Or will one of them walk out of the restaurant for good?
See you later.
That's next on Kitchen Nightmares. After a terrible lunch service, Chef Ramsay wants to meet Kata's business partner, Marcelo, as well as the chefs responsible for his meal.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Yeah, good. And this is?
Eduardo.
Eduardo. Okay, let me just tell you something. Lunch was a disaster. Who is the head chef?
I'm the head chef.
You're the head chef?
Yes.
Talk to me about the black beans. Was that perfect?
No, the beans were not perfect. It was salty.
Who cooked the tilapia?
I cooked
it. It was raw. I could hear a lot of shouting. What? Is that normal?
That's all we hear every day.
What do you mean every day?
Every single day. He aggravates everybody.
Kata's always pushing me. Just say, listen, do your thing. Let me do my thing. But she's in her thing and in my thing all together.
Checking your performance.
You're not my boss.
I'm not your boss, but your partner.
You know what happened when you are on top of me? Everything got worse.
You still live together?
No, we separated. He lives in his own apartment, and I live here in the building.
Upstairs?
Upstairs.
Literally upstairs.
Oh, dear. Okay, right now, I need some fresh air. I'm gonna go for a walk, and I'll be in service tonight, watching everything, and try to do a better job than you did for me lunchtime. Okay? I'll be back.
Even with Chef Ramsay, there's absolutely no hope for this restaurant to survive.
After a miserable lunch, Chef Ramsay wants to see how this feuding couple handles dinner service.
Guys, Chef Ramsay's here. Please keep focused and do everything according. Don't send everything out that is not right.
I think she used long-lasting battery because she's stuck and talk and talk and talk and talk and talk and talk. Catalina, the pretty girl owner of the restaurant, giving orders to everybody and don't do nothing. She don't do nothing.
What's all that on the windows there? What is all that?
The blue borders? Yes. It's just for decoration.
Decoration?
Decoration, that's it.
Water, but what have you colored it with?
The toilet bowls.
Toilet bowls?
I make the blue water and I put it on it to put it in the
game. I mean, I've heard of restaurants bottling water, but
it's just for decoration.
Just for decoration.
Not for drink. Not for consumption.
Unless you've eaten here.
Word has spread of Chef Ramsay's arrival in Brooklyn.
Hi, how are you?
And Mojitos is busier than usual.
You guys have a reservation?
Yeah.
Either one of these two tables. Enjoy your dinner, guys.
With the first orders in, Chef Ramsay is looking forward to seeing the head chef in action.
Marcel.
Are you expediting?
Yes.
You are. You gotta open up, at least talk.
The kitchen staff, we do so much better without Marcel.
Stop putting the tickets that I'm already starting there here because it's all me up.
He doesn't know what the hell he's doing.
He's not appetizer.
It is an appetizer.
Oh, yeah, you're right. What is that for?
That's for
A3.
Yes.
No, I need it. Look.
Clearly, Marcelo has no control of his kitchen.
Oh, my God.
Not only is food slowly making its way to the dining room, the dishes are not exactly being well received.
It's horrible. Really.
What's wrong with the chef?
What's up with these empanadas? Can I have a regular stuff?
All right. I'll be happy to help them fix that for you, okay?
What's the matter?
They're undercooked. They want them cooked a little bit more.
Oh. Marcelo, please keep checking that everything that comes out is good.
We check it already. We got it.
Marcelo doesn't expedite. He doesn't have consistency. He just, like, send things out just to get them out of the way.
They ordered the shrimp quesadilla, but the gentleman says that he really doesn't like it.
Would you like to order something instead of that? I don't want you to go home hungry. All right. No problem. I'm sorry, guys. Do you have this? Question. Who made this? You guys should know better. How can you allow food to come out like that nasty?
No nasty at all. We are doing something.
You're going to tell me the quesadilla is supposed to be crispy and it was like soggy?
No,
and
it's crispy. It's not crispy.
It's not soggy. It's supposed to be nicer.
The bad part of Kata is that she's not actually hands-on. She's just adding fire.
You're trying to sabotage it.
She's making the situation worse.
No, but you're not doing it right.
I'm painting.
You're not doing it right.
Perfect. Perfect.
It's not perfect.
Oh, dear. Marcello, a beaten man. He's soulless. If that's expediting, well, he may as well be sat at home. Kata, well, she can definitely talk, but she's not doing anything. Talk, but nothing being done. Kitchen's in chaos, and the restaurant is sinking.
It's cold. I don't want it. I'm done.
Chef Ramsay has seen enough of this service. Customers are unhappy. And there's chaos in the kitchen. So he decides to take a break from the madness and check out the food storage.
Look at all this food in here.
And what he finds is an outrageous amount of food for a failing restaurant.
How much produce is in this fridge? Trays and trays of produce. Look, and they've put the fresh one at the front, and at the back, you've got the squidgy one. Marinated skirt. No, tilapia. That
is what you call dry chicken. That's more chicken. There must be thousands and thousands of dollars worth of food here.
If their cash flow is in the this is a big reason why.
Thank you very much. Have a good night, guys.
After observing dinner service, Chef Ramsay now knows that Mojito's problems are not just confined to a bad relationship.
I don't argue for no reason.
And subpar food.
We'll never come here again.
In fact, Mojito's is in much worse shape than he thought.
Right, let's start off with tonight's dinner service. Or shall I say a disservice? Customers pissed off. Dishes been returned. If each and every one of you want this restaurant to work, you all have to reach for a standard, whether you're serving food, whether you're cooking food, or whether you're sending food. At the end of service, I pop downstairs. Who does the purchasing in here? Who buys the fish, the meat, and the vegetables?
Me. Mashallah.
Stay there.
Let me just show you something.
Right now, I'm really nervous because I don't know what's gonna happen.
Just take that out for me, please. Just bring the whole tray out for me.
I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know what to expect. I'm scared.
Mojito's is over $300,000 in debt.
I am amazed.
What Chef Ramsay found in the basement is one of the reasons why.
Oh, no. I don't even want to look.
Thanks. Thank you. Okay.
I was speechless. How can Marcelo allow something like this to happen?
I've never seen such waste in my entire life. You've got enough food down there to serve a banquet of 5,000. There's seven of these down there. Seven.
I don't know if I'm gonna kill Eduardo first or I'm gonna kill myself first.
This is rapidly shutting down the restaurant. I've got some work to do, and I've got to get out of here, guys. That makes me feel sick.
I'm the owner, and this is my kitchen. This is my place. I should be the one taking control of the situation.
Chef Ramsay uncovered many problems at Mojito's, but for this restaurant to ever work properly, he has to understand the issues between Marcelo and Cotta. So he spends the morning with both of them.
Okay. All I've seen so far is a bossy, angry little princess. The restaurant's suffering on the back of both of you constantly hurting each other. He does it to you, you do it to him, and it's so sad. And it's affecting everybody else down the line.
It's embarrassing.
Take me back 7 years when you got married.
We are together all time. Everybody say, you are the perfect couple. We decide to have a baby. So we started to do fertilization process.
The IVF.
And nothing happened.
I was putting everything into it, and I was willing to sacrifice and to do and go through the treatment, but it was no support from him. Like, while I was on the treatment, injecting myself, he was out partying with friends. I was being left alone. That's when I'm like, no, not happening. You're not coming home to me at 7 o'clock in the morning. I'm your wife.
Yeah.
So that's when everything started going wrong.
How did the marriage break down?
She go to Florida for 1.5 years in Miami.
Did she meet somebody else in Miami? Did she meet another man in Miami?
Yeah.
I took a trip. During the trip, I decided that I was going to leave him. You're not making me happy. I'm not making you happy. Go your way, I'll go my way.
Do you think it's time that one of you says goodbye to the business and give each other space?
I think we'll be very healthy. I want Cata off of this business. She don't have any idea of how run a business. She don't do nothing.
How important is the business for you?
It's everything for me. The person that I was married to, that person doesn't exist anymore. He's gone. And I have to move on. And that's what I'm doing. And I take the loss of my marriage. And I think that's the price that I have to pay for my business. So I'm taking care of my business. That's all I have left. Whatever it takes, I'll go to the end. Until I feel that there's nothing else that I can do.
I've got a plan. I need to see you like it was 4.5, 5 years ago. You know, funny, confident, and no bickering.
I'm committed.
Okay, come thank you. Come here. Stand strong. Okay. Thank you.
Marcelo and I, if we don't find a way to communicate, if we don't find a way to get to an agreement, the restaurant is gonna go down the drain. But Marcelo really drives me crazy. I don't think it's gonna work ever.
While Kata and Marcelo have both lost their passion for each other, Chef Ramsay wants to know if they still have their passion for the food.
One thing I haven't seen since I've been here is you two working together. So that's what exactly we're gonna do now. With all these ingredients in front of you, cook me something authentic, something Cuban, and do it together.
Oh gosh, are we gonna be able to do this?
Hey, no arguing, yes?
We can be together at the kitchen.
So, okay, I'll make the shrimp with the pineapple sauce.
Okay, let me do the fricassee.
Marcelo wanted to make chicken, but I wanted to do my shrimp. So we started cooking two dishes instead of one.
Very quiet in here. Everything okay?
Everything good.
Everything's good. Is this dish done together?
We're doing two dishes.
I want to see you two Muppets work together. One dish. Oh my God.
That's not gonna happen.
Okay, okay, okay. Don't freak, just keep moving.
Okay.
One dish.
Two. 50-50.
Oh, unbelievable. Okay. Chicken with potatoes. Whose idea was it to do the shrimp? Whose was it?
Me. Mm-hmm. Simple flavors. I think I did a much better job than Marcelo.
I like that.
Nice.
That's nice. What is that?
Chicken fricassee.
Presentation, it's not as attractive as a shrimp, clearly. Not blow me away, it's mediocre. The shrimp is the dish I'd love to pay for in a local Cuban restaurant. We'll do that as a special tonight, yes?
Makes me feel wonderful that the dish has been chosen for those specials by Chef Ramsay. An honor.
Okay, good. Now do me one more favor. F out together through the door. See if you can just manage walking out together.
While Chef Ramsay works on another special with Chef Eduardo.
Right, let's do something together, yes?
Something special is also happening out in the dining room.
Marcelo.
Kata and Marcelo are communicating.
I wanted to ask you if you want to switch tonight. I'll be in the kitchen. You want to be here? If you come out here, you stay up front. You just, like, follow the lead. Works? We got to talk to Chef Ramsay if he allows us to do that. If he allows it, I'll go into the kitchen.
The people at the kitchen going to run out. With her attitude, with her... She's a nightmare.
Coming up on Kitchen Nightmares.
I'm the boss here. Remember who I am.
Kata's on the warpath in the kitchen.
If I want to scream, I can do it.
And nothing?
He's standing there doing nothing.
Or nobody.
I'll do it myself.
Will get in her way.
But you have to listen to me. Everything is a disaster.
And the dining room led by Marcelo is a circus.
Don't bounce around like a monkey.
Will this soap opera have a happy ending? Or will mojitos go up in flames?
Marcelo, get out of the kitchen. Get out of the kitchen.
That's next on Kitchen Nightmares. Chef Ramsay's plan for tonight's dinner service features his garlic chicken and Kata shrimp with mango salsa.
Tonight's gonna be a lot better than we had last night, yes?
Yes. Yes.
But Kata has a plan of her own.
Chef Ramsay, we're gonna be switching places. Marcelo and I are gonna be in the kitchen starting. He's gonna be front house.
I mean, that sounds great. Who came to that decision?
We both did, yes.
Woo! Round of applause. That's amazing! Wow! Everybody
Everybody's happy.
So I want fast, efficient service, hot food, and more importantly, you've got to show me that you can handle those small changes. Expedite, host, serve, cook. Woo! Let's go, yeah? Yeah.
Hey, how are you?
Yeah.
Welcome to Mojito.
Thank you.
Don't point it.
I'm definitely really nervous about tonight's dinner service.
I don't think Marcelo does well in the front of the house.
Okay, don't bounce around like a monkey, yeah? Walk in the dining room.
As patrons enter the restaurant,
welcome to Mojito.
You will find the specials over here.
Kata takes the helm in the kitchen.
While you work for me, I'm your boss. So you're here and fryer. This is your section.
I can definitely handle pressure in the back of the house.
You need more chicken than vegetables.
And I know I'm gonna do a much better work than Marcelo.
How you doing, guys?
We have a couple of specials tonight.
It's a lemon and garlic garden chicken.
We also have two jumbo grilled shrimp with a tropical salsa.
We'll take one of those.
Okay.
You want the chicken special? Thank you so much.
Here we go, guys. First order, yes?
Guacamole and cheese, beef empanadas, and then we're gonna have a garlic chicken, pescado marinero, ropavilla, churrasco de carne. I'll tell you what to throw the churrasco, and one order of empanadas, one chicken, one beef. Let me have another jumbo shrimp and one guacamole.
No, two chicken special.
Thank you, team. Another order of the jumbo shrimp special.
Well done.
Tonight's dinner service is off to a good start.
Good.
Kata has control of the kitchen.
One chicken.
Thank you so much.
And customers are enjoying the specials.
I don't know why, but it feels better tonight. Why
way better.
Why?
Catalina is awesome in the kitchen.
Two guacamole and chips, one tropical shrimp.
Marcelo's actually better in the front because it's less stress on him.
Señor, thank you so much.
So he's better in the front, she's better in the kitchen?
Yeah, I believe so.
Three more chickens in total. Yeah.
You look so good and composed back here. That's how you do it.
Hello.
Holler back, baby. Holler back.
Thank you, baby. All the love.
This restaurant is still chaotic, but there's a massive significant difference. Kata can handle pressure 1,000 times better than Marcelo, and the good news is the specials are flying out.
While the new specials are a big hit with the diners,
really good.
The original menu is striking out.
I have to get something else, just a very strange taste to it.
Coming up.
What's wrong?
He didn't like the, his has a strange taste.
Strange taste?
Yes.
Okay, let's go, guys. Pick up.
Kata, this steak was a strange taste. Can I have ropavilla instead?
Yes.
It's on the window.
Come on, Kata, wake up.
Keep it respectful. Remember who I am. Don't give me attitude, because I don't need to give you attitude. I'm the boss, like it or not. You have to listen to me.
You waiting for your side still, right?
Yes, he's getting
it. Okay.
It's not working. What is it for?
Wait, let me have the ticket. What's the mess for the ticket? I'm feeling a lot of pressure. There's lost tickets. There's food coming out wrong. Everything is a disaster. And Chef Ramsay is watching us.
I need a container for their tickets, an ice bucket. I need a spike in the kitchen because we're losing tickets.
For a Cubano sandwich, right?
My God, those sandwiches are not ready yet?
Almost done.
When we get busy, Kata loses herself. She becomes very confused.
We have one order of tropical shrimp.
That went out already.
Everything went out?
She doesn't know what really is going on.
Wait, but mommy, hold on.
It's chaos.
It's an hour and a half into dinner service, and the restaurant is in utter turmoil.
What is it for?
There are lost orders.
I need a spike in the kitchen because we're losing tickets.
Unhappy customers.
It tastes like fast food.
And Kata is spinning out of control.
Wait, mommy, hold on.
Mojitos is on the rocks once again.
It's not getting cold. We cannot have any more food waiting for
Kata,
one order.
You're calling one order for one ticket like this.
No.
One thing, Brad.
You
five minutes
calling
later.
It.
Un pecado marinero. 5 minutes later.
Marcelo, get out of the kitchen. Get out of the kitchen.
She become like a tiger. Get out of the kitchen. Go out.
Out of the kitchen. Okay, enough. Get out of the kitchen.
What's wrong with this girl? She's crazy.
Perfect. Thank you.
That doesn't leave there, yeah?
Yeah.
The kitchen is getting behind. Everything is getting... It's not coming out right. Everything's going wrong. I have to, like, take control and do something. Take some action.
All right, guys. This order, we have to make it perfect. Perfect.
Yeah, here we go, yeah?
Okay, so you need two churrasco medium, two garden chickens, one pescado marinero, one milanesa breaded. Is the chicken coming?
Yeah.
B1.
After a good start, a miserable middle, ricotta pushes for a strong finish.
Take that.
Kata seems to be doing better.
Two chickens, yes.
Nice.
Now she's got a better grip on tickets, on expediting.
Take that chicken, Mamor. Go team.
Brilliant, well done.
Tonight was so much better than last night. A lot smoother.
Cheers. Take care. Good night.
After an up-and-down service, Chef Ramsay knows that for mojitos to reach its potential...
That is beautiful.
Kata and Marcelo have to be on the same page.
Okay, first of all, tonight was better. But let me tell you, we can't just get by on two specials. We need to be consistent. So it was a small step forward. Now we have to take a giant leap forward. That will be done tomorrow. We're going to relaunch this restaurant. I'm going to be working on the menu throughout the whole night. But before I leave you here, I'm going to ask you a very serious question. And I spent a lot of time with both of you, and I totally accept that the possibility of a husband and wife scenario is not on the cards. That is not going to happen. But you both own the place. And what I need to know from both of you is that are you prepared to put the grievances, your egos, your frustrations, your anger aside and completely focus on your baby? And that is the Mojito Restaurant. Because if you can do that, you've got a strong possibility of making this place work. If you can't, then we have a big problem. Good night.
Let's go. I hope in my heart Kat and me can work together. I think we're gonna be on track.
With the belief that Kata and Marcelo are committed to working together, Chef Ramsay and his team spend the night giving mojitos a much-needed makeover.
Good morning. Welcome to Mojitos.
Wow.
The new mojitos, yes? Doesn't it feel twice as big? Hello, Cuba.
This looks amazing.
Blocking out all that natural light was crazy. Look how bright this place is.
It looks fresh.
Open.
First thing that's gone missing are the 500 bottles that were stopping all that natural light.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Take a look at where your bottles have gone. Look, no more blue rinse cleaner.
It's the new beginning of the restaurant.
Kata, what do you think?
This is amazing. This is a huge step moving forward. And this has, like, inspired us and, like, give everyone the spark that we were missing to keep going and keep working hard.
Great restaurant. Yes?
Yes.
Now you need a proper menu. Wow. So, Macho, the menu's been cut in half. Why? We need speeds.
Yes.
Thanks, God.
We keep it small.
Yes.
We keep it fresh.
Please.
And more importantly, we no longer need to keep 10,000 worth of ingredients downstairs that's not been turned. Yes?
Yes.
You happy?
Extremely.
Yeah? Sad. Good.
Unbelievable.
And I see Kata crying like a baby. Wow. I really feel really happy for her. I'm so happy, so happy.
Today is the beginning of a new chapter inside Mojitos.
Thank you.
Come
so
here, you.
Much.
Come
Thank
here.
You.
You little firecracker.
Hey.
This is the best.
Yes,
this is the best.
With the renovation done and Marcelo and Kato's relationship on the mend, Chef Ramsay has done away with the cafeteria-style food and in its place, contemporary Cuban cuisine.
Look at the difference in the portion size first. Baked cod, meatballs, entrees, slow-roast pork, braised short rib, authentic and sumptuous. It's a lot less, but visually, it's beautiful.
From the new menu, I find a lot of exciting new things. Wow, meatballs, wow.
I'm so excited. I'm really looking forward for tonight.
For relaunch night, with Chef Ramsay's blessing, Cotta and Marcello decide to work the front of the house, greeting customers, leaving Chef Eduardo in charge of the kitchen.
You convinced you can do it?
Yeah.
Marcello, 2 seconds. I've managed to get a really amazing VIP guest here this evening. He's the president of the Brooklyn Borough. Look after him, yeah?
Thank you, we will. Okay. Everything's on the line tonight. Marcel and I have to come together, otherwise we're gonna fail. Welcome to Mojito. How many are you guys?
Four.
Follow me this way, guys.
Looks good in here.
Yeah, it should be a lot further.
Are you guys ready? Cubans up, it's okay?
For the first time in 5 years, Brooklyn's only Cuban restaurant clearly has a buzz in the dining room.
Awesome. Thank you, gentlemen, so much.
And as for the kitchen, it's a different story.
Very quiet here, guys. Huh? Eddie, 2 orders on. Yeah, nothing called out. You're not going to call the orders out to the team? Those tickets come in, you've got to be in control, big boy, yes?
Sir.
Good man.
Your food should be out any minute, okay? Pick up.
With Chef Eduardo's lack of communication, food is leaving the kitchen slowly.
Be right back with the beans.
And when it does arrive in the dining room, some customers receive dishes they didn't even order.
Had a Cuban sandwich?
Yeah.
Guys,
what?
F5 is missing a Cuban.
I told him.
What came back?
This babe, that's because they ordered a Cuban sandwich.
Not the pork?
Not the pork.
Unbelievable.
Look at me now. You've got to call out the orders because he's cooking blind.
Okay.
Yeah, so he needs some form of direction, yeah?
And don't forget to send Bean out with every order.
Oh,
restaurant's full, great atmosphere. Unfortunately, food started coming back and Eduardo has shut down. Not tonight, because this could be a disaster.
I thought they got 6.
Well, yeah. We did order 6. Now they're all chicken.
Yeah,
we ordered a mix of all the different flavors and everything.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. They got obviously their information mixed up back there.
I see tickets coming back because Eduardo was completely lost.
Hey guys, F4 is missing more empanadas. They have one of each.
Oh, we got a little too fast.
Come on, man. Welcome to Mojito.
Oh, thank you.
Enjoy the food, and this is the table special for you, okay? Yes. The president of the borough is here, and the kitchen is a disaster. Completely disaster.
What is this? So we can start taking it. What table?
The steak's cold as well.
The president of the borough is here. Eddie's not expediting, he's not talking, he's not communicating. If Eddie doesn't start to speak up, this kitchen's gonna go down.
Give me a break.
It's relaunch night, and the president of the Brooklyn Borough has arrived.
Welcome to Mojito.
And the timing couldn't be worse. Eduardo is a mess, and Chef Ramsay knows he has to step in.
Turn those steaks over. 2 seconds with me, 2 seconds. Literally 2 seconds. Come on, what's the matter?
Huh?
What's the matter?
I'm all over the place.
But what you're not doing for you, for me, for the restaurant, no one's talking.
Okay, I'm gonna put my dishwasher into frying because I need
do something.
Okay, I guess.
Okay?
Okay.
Come on, Eddie.
I got you.
Me? Talk.
Yes, chef.
Just do something, but talk. Come on.
Yes, chef. Okay.
You can do it. Come here.
Cuba, come here.
The president of the borough is here, and the kitchen is a nightmare right now. I have to do something, and I have to do it now.
Here we go.
Let's go. Let's expedite this.
We're concentrating a pescado marinero, ropa vieja, arroz con pollo, white meat only, churrasco pork. Okay?
Nice. Here we go.
That's the most important order of the night.
That's one guy we cannot afford to piss off tonight.
Exactly. Arroz con pollo. The new pernil and the arroz con pollo. Fish?
Yeah, fish coming
out
right now. Excellent.
The arroz. I need another ropa vieja more. Beautiful, beautiful.
Guys, we need more plantains. Can we have more?
It's coming in 5. Give me 5. Thank you.
Brilliant.
Thank you. Hi, buddy.
Kata and me are working together well again. I'm gonna do this and you do that.
Let's go.
With Cotta and Marcello finally working together as a team.
All right.
The kitchen is back on track.
This is B3?
B3.
And now the only thing left to make the night a success is satisfying the borough president.
How was everything here?
Cheers,
yeah, they loved everything.
Yeah, baby. Yeah!
Marcelo took control of the whole situation. He was very put together, very calm, very relaxed. He really got things going, and that made me gain more respect for him.
Well, it means a lot for us for you guys to be here, and I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Nice to see you. Best wishes. Thank you.
That's it? I think that the passion is back. I'm back again.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Have a good night.
Cata and Marcelo came together like the team they once were, and Mojito's relaunch was a success.
Right, tonight wasn't perfect, but I did see one thing that I haven't witnessed at Mojito's for the first time, and that was teamwork. Well done. What do you think about the future of this restaurant now?
Before it was really uncertain. We didn't know if we were going to last a month, a week, a day. Now we have a long-term future.
It's up to both of you. Are you seriously willing to put your past aside and commit to your baby?
I already start. I feel great this night. I get the energy that I had 5 years ago.
It feels great to see Marcelo smile. Him showing his emotions, it just started right in my heart.
Do me a favor. Tell each other how important it is.
You are my partner. And I need your support, and I need your commitment. So if you're committed to me, I'll be 110, 120, 200 committed to you to make it work and to the restaurant.
I need you to continue. You are the half of that.
I'm gonna do everything that it takes to make it work.
You guys work well together. Tonight proved that.
I feel in my heart that I get Cata back. I get my partner back.
Don't stop. You'd be mad to. Come on, my darling. Thank you. Good to see you guys. Great team. What a night. When I first arrived, I honestly didn't think it was possible that Cata and Marcelo could actually work together, but tonight they proved me wrong. Now, I'm wondering, if the restaurant that actually ruined the marriage could now be the restaurant that saves their marriage. Me, only time will tell. You live in hope. Get me a strong mojito.
After Gordon's departure, Marcelo and Cata were determined to follow his advice.
We need to work as a team. We need to be able to pay all this.
Thanks to Gordon's smaller menu, Marcelo buys less produce, saving nearly $10,000 a month. And he and Cata wasted no time promoting the new mojitos.
We want to invite everyone to come and shake it up on Mojito.
They got the word out to the community by using the popular Brooklyn flea market, winning rave reviews.
It's really good.
Good?
Yeah, and I can taste the spices in there. It's very rich.
More importantly, Marcelo and Cata are fighting less and laughing more.